we do hope that any help that you need from us to make your journal, you know, really listed in Scopus, we will be happy to do.
Definitely.
Right? Okay. Now I request the audience to please share their comments and suggestions. Yeah. Manoj sir.
Okay. Yeah, I have two small questions.
Yes, sir.
Dr. Sushil, you had given a good lecture, so congratulations for that.
You
mentioned that, you know, publication in open access journals is better because you have more download citations, etc. But the problem is most of them, they are not listed in JCI or SCI, etc. So what is your comment on that?
Here I have already pointed out that these are the matrices only to just the journal only, not only the article, and most of the researchers, young researchers and traditional researchers are not aware and made it a parameter, and our system actually is following to that. If we will publish in impact factor journal only, then we will basically reputed researchers and all these things. But in case of open access journal, thing is what, that when again I am putting one question here, why those people basically are making their journal open access, those were earlier the subscription based journal? We have to understand it, sir.
Even nature has gone towards golden open access recently, just a month ago.
Fund basically European Commission have the funds, are providing the fund and making the policy when they are providing fund to the fundee, that they have to publish their article only in open access journal, irrespective to the impact factor, H index and other things, and indexing into the Scopus or Web of Science.
Okay, that's fine. Second question is that you mentioned that you will apply for SCI Scopus listing by 2022. So my question is, what are the requirements and what makes you keep on waiting till 2022 and not apply now?
I have applied earlier also, but due to some other, not some other, only one other, what they did, they published actually a duplicate paper in our journal. He basically, I don't want to point out at this platform, they publish and frequently they publish article in our journal, and I basically got this kind of feedback from the Scopus and directory of open access journal that we are not indexing your journal, and they just give me a hint. So I have just observed all the article that what is going on. Then I came to know about one person. That person basically publishing similar type of article and same article. What basically he did, he just basically changed the scale, changed the paragraph. He was manipulating everything. This was one of the reasons. I can share the Scopus report and they give me good feedback. And now they give me 2 years time, and they are saying if you will publish the high quality, because to be indexed into the Scopus and Web of Science, one thing is very important, that the authors H index, again, it matters for because this is the role that that I want, I don't want to say publicly. These are the only things by which we are going to the and impact factor and H index. So we have to list it only those other, those who have good H index and impact factor only, then they will provide. And sir,
this much, yeah. I think this one should be an eye opener to all the, you know, researchers. See, unless until we really publish in our own journals, our journals will not go into Scopus. So I think we all should encourage and try to publish our work in this kind of journals, so that, you know, they'll also, after all, what is listed in Scopus, because they have been for very long publishing from, I think, maybe 50s or 60s or 70s, so they are already in Scopus, and the new journals can also come into Scopus or can come into, you know, really the top rated journals only when we publish into them.